We have a really interesting question from Denmark. Fleming asks, how does Google view font replacement? And they mentioned several different types. Are some methods better than others? Are all good, all bad? So we have mentioned some specific stuff like Cypher that, you know, we're okay with. But again, think about this. You want to basically show the same content to users than you that you do to Googlebot. And so as much as possible, you want to show the same actual content. So we've said that having fonts using methods like Cypher is okay, but ideally, you might concentrate on some of the newer stuff that has been happening in this space. So if you search for web fonts, I think Google, for example, has a web font directory of over 100 different web fonts. So now we're starting to get to the point where if you use one of these types of commonly available fonts, you don't even have to do font replacement using the traditional techniques. It's actual letters that are selectable and copy and pastable in your browser. So it's not the case that we tend to see a lot of deception and a lot of abuse. You know, if you were to have a logo here and then underneath the logo have text that says, that's hidden, that says, you know, buy cheap Viagra, debt consolidation, mortgages online, that sort of stuff, then that could be viewed as deceptive. But if the text that's in, you know, the font replacement technique is the same as what is in the logo, then you should be in pretty good shape. However, I would encourage people to check out some of this newer stuff because the newer stuff doesn't actually have to do some of these, you know, techniques. Rather, it's the actual letters and it's just using different ways of marking that up so that the browser, it looks really good, and yet at the same time, the real text is there. And so search engines are able to index it and process it just like they would normal text.